So, good morning, my dear students. My name is Dr. K.C.H. Chaparo, working as an associate professor in Mechanical Department, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. So, in previous classes, we discussed how to solve the LP problems by different methods. Okay. So, in this class, I would like to explain the transportation models. So, transportation is very important to think. So, just like it is the very familiar thing or familiar just like activity in our daily lives. So, because of transportation of products from the manufacturing sector to warehouses or just like distribution centers. So, these are very needed, just like frequent or just like daily activities, so in our lives. Okay, so just like for that one, just this transportation problems are mainly used to identify the optimized route to minimize the transportation cost. So that is the main object. Okay. So to solve the transportation problems or to solve the to find the optimized route, just like there are mainly there are two steps. Okay, so it means so to solve the transportation problem, there are two steps are there. First one is the finding the initial basic feasible solution. First of all, you have to find the initial basic feasible solution. Next to finding the optimal solution. Okay. To find the initial basic feasible solution, so there are three methods or three rules. The first one is the northwest corner rule. Second one is the lowest cost method. Third one is the Vogel's approximation method. Okay, so by using three methods, we can solve the basic, initial basic feasible solution. Okay, so then you have to go for the next procedure steps, that is the finding of the optimal solution. So to find the optimal solution, there are two steps. So two methods, the one is the stepping stone method, another one is the MODI method. Okay, so in this way, transportation problems will be carried out, will be solved by the two processes. The first one is the two steps. First step is the finding the initial basic feasible solution by three methods. So next one, second one is the finding the optimal solution by two methods, either stepping stone method or MODI method. So special cases is the unbalanced transportation problems. So if the unbalanced transportation problems are given, you have to convert those problems into balanced transportation problems. Balanced means number of demands is equal to number of supplies should be equal. Okay, number of columns should be equal to number of rows. Next to degeneracy. So we'll see what is degeneracy, all these things. So just like I want to give the brief description about the transportation. This is the very important activity in our lives, because of transportation of goods from one place to another place. This is very important, very needed also. Okay. There are four manufacturing sectors are there, and five distribution centers are there. So totally 4 into 5, so 20 routes are available to move the those finished product to distribution centers. So there are 20 routes. Then you have to identify which route is the optimal route. It means so by which route we will get the low cost of the transportation. Okay, so that is the very important. So for the managers to decrease the transportation cost and increase the productivity. Okay, So the ultimate goal is the interactive procedure that finds the least costly, just like means of moving products. So from a service of sources, just like map access sectors to series of destinations, just like distribution centers. Okay. So can be used to help the resolve distribution location decisions also. Okay. Which product should be shifted to which distribution center, or which product are shifted to which warehouse. Okay. So that like to take those decisions in order to decrease the transportation cost. Okay. So that is the very important. Okay. So we can say it is a special case of linear programming. So we already learned about the linear programming. It is also a special case of special class of linear programming. Okay. To solve the transportation problems, so three things should be needed. Okay. So three things should be known or should be should be revealed. Okay. The first one is the origin points. So origin points and capacity or supply of a period. Okay. So just origin points. So origin points give the capacity or supply for the period. Okay. So next to destination points. So destination points gives the demands. So demands per period. Okay. So you should know the supply and you should know the demand. Okay. Next to cost of shipping. So cost of shipping one unit to, from each origin to each destination. Okay. So just like suppose this is the origin point. So this is the destination point. Okay. So to transfer or to move this one unit or in one, suppose if it is a car manufacturing process. So moving of one car from this manufacturing sector to this destination center or distribution center. So suppose the cost may be so less than 100 rupees or 5 rupees anything. So this value should be needed. So cost of shipping. So cost of shipping of one unit from each origin to each destination. This values also should be needed. So finally, so supply should be needed, demand should be needed, cost of shipping also should be needed. If you know these three values, then you can solve the transportation problem. Okay. So we'll see. Just like here one numerical is given, just like based upon this numerical, we will try to understand the procedure steps of the transportation. Okay. So in next class, we will see just like some more numericals based upon the transportation. So for solving those numericals by transportation model. Okay. So this is the just like example, both tubes are produced in three factories. The factory names are given. Factory D and factory E and factory F. Okay. So the product is shipped to the distributors. So distributors are warehouses. Okay. So warehouse A and warehouse B and warehouse C. Okay. So these are situated, these are placed in different cities. Okay. In railroad. So way also given railroad. Okay. Each factory is able to supply. So supply values are given. So supply the following number of units. So factory D can supply 100 units. Factory E can supply 300 units and factory F can supply 300 units. Okay. So these are the supply values. So next to demand values, distribution, the distribution requires the following units. It means demand value, warehouse A. So demands just like 300 units, warehouse B 200 units and warehouse C is equal to 200 units. Here just like supply and demand values are given. So remaining transportation cost of shipping is given in the table form. Okay. So three things. So we got the three things. Okay. So supply values are given, demand values are given, cost of shipping. Cost of shipping means, so shipping of one product from factory D to warehouse A, it takes 5 rupees cost. Okay. So similarly, so just like one product from shipping of one product from D to warehouse B, that takes 4 rupees. So similarly, one product from factory D to factory D to warehouse C, that takes 3 rupees. So this is a shipping cost, transportation cost of each product. Okay. So these are the values. If you know the three values, then you go for the transportation models. Okay. Just like three destinations and three factories are given. The factory, this is the factory D, factory E and factory F. Okay. So these are the warehouse A, warehouse B and warehouse C in different cities are. So these warehouses are placed or situated. Okay. So just like you can ship the products from factory F to warehouse A, warehouse B and warehouse C. Okay. Warehouse A takes just like a different cost and warehouse B takes transportation cost is different, and for the warehouse C, transportation cost is different. Okay. You have to identify which route is feasible route, or which route is the optimized route to decrease the transportation cost. So identification of that route is very important. So we can identify that route just like by transportation model. Okay. So just like we can ship the products from factory E to warehouse A and warehouse B and warehouse C, and we can ship the products from factory D to warehouse A, warehouse B and warehouse C, just like here. So totally 3 into 3, 9 routes are there. Okay. So shipping of products from the factory to warehouses. So just like we have to identify which route is just like optimized route. So just like to decrease the transportation cost. So that is the ultimate goal of transportation models. Okay. Yeah, here tabular form. So just like we have to rewrite or formulate the word form numerical into tabular form. Okay. So that is very important. So there are three factories are given, factory D and factory E and factory C, and warehouse A and warehouse B and warehouse C is given. So just like supply values of the factory D, that is the 100. So just like factory F can supply 300 and factory C can supply 300. So this is the supply values. So these are the warehouses demand values. Okay. So just like warehouse A requires 300 units capacity, and warehouse B capacity is equal to 200. So demanding value is equal to 200. More than 200 they cannot. So we cannot store in that warehouse B. Okay. Warehouse C, the capacity rate or demand rate is equal to 200. Okay. So these are the values. So next to these values are also given shipping values. So just like shipping of one unit from factory C to warehouse B. Factory C to warehouse B. Okay. So it means 5 rupees takes from the movement of or transportation of one unit of product from factory D to warehouse A. Okay. Similarly, so cost of moving of one unit of any product from factory D to warehouse B, that takes 4 rupees. Okay. So similarly, from factory D to warehouse C, that takes 3 rupees. So this is the shipping cost of each unit, not all the products. Okay. Remember that one. So here we got the just like three values: supply values, demand values, and shipping values. If you know these three values, then you can solve the transportation model. So to solve any transportation model problems, just like we should know these three values: supply, demand, and shipping values. Okay. So to solve this, to solve the transportation model, so it includes two steps. One is the finding of the initial basic feasible solution. Next one, finding the optimization solution. Okay, so first off, we'll see the understand the given problem, formulate it into standard form. It means convert the just like word form which was given in the numerical, just like word form numerical into tabular form. Okay, so formation, that is the very important. Next, check the equality of the total supply and demand. Okay, so if it is the just like what is that? Okay, so we have to equal transportation models or unequal transportation model. We have to identify that one. Equal means number of supply is equal to number of demands. Here you can see here, so number of demands, so 300, so plus 200 plus 200, so total is equal to 700. So number of supplies is equal to 100 plus 300 plus 300, 700. So this is the equal in form. Okay, so just like if it is unequal form, just like we have to add some dummy columns or dummy rows. I will explain later also, no problem. So just like you have to check the equality of the total supply and demand. Okay, if not, if the total supply is equal to total demand, so if the total supply is not equal to total demand, so just like we need to balance by creating the dummy row or dummy columns. We have to add dummy column or we have to add dummy rows. Okay, so assign zero transportation cost for the dummy columns and dummy rows. You have to give the zero cost. Okay, so just like we have to remember that one also. So next, how many ship of units should be transported from each demand to each destination? So that is expressed by XIZ. Okay, so I is the factory, J is the distribution center. You have to remember that one also. So step three, just find the initial basic feasible solution. Initial basic feasible solution. To find that initial basic feasible solution, you know that there are three methods. One is the northwest corner rule, and second one is the least cost method, third one is the Vogel's approximation method. Okay, so Vogel's approximation method. So by using any one of these three, we can find the initial basic feasible solution. After completion of initial basic feasible solution, then you go for the optimization solution. For the optimization solution also, there are two methods. One is the just like stepping stone method, another one is the MODI method. Okay, by using any one of that one, you can solve the optimality test. Okay, so that, so final last one, last step is the, so finding the optimal solution and the optimal transportation cost. Optimal, so if you get the optimal solution, then you have to find the optimal transportation cost. How to find, I will explain later. Okay, so this is the just like same procedure steps. So okay, first of all, finding the initial basic feasible solution. So already explained that one. To find the initial basic feasible solution, there are three methods. First one is the northwest corner method, second one is the least cost method, third one is the Vogel's approximation method. So here in this class, first of all, we will see the northwest corner rule, how to apply the northwest corner rule to solve the initial basic feasible solution. Okay, so these are the procedure steps, just like you can follow and you can solve the numerical by using this NWC R rule. Okay, C rule. So start in the upper left to left hand cell, just like start in the upper left hand cell. It means that is the northwest corner. Northwest corner. So you know that just like directions, this is the east, this is the west, this is the north, this is the south. Okay, so northwest corner. Northwest corner means this is the north, this is the west. This, so this portion is the northwest corner cell. So we have to identify the, we have to identify the, in tabular form, identify the, so northwest corner cell, northwest corner cell. So what is the northwest corner cell? Just like that is the left side, upper side. Okay, left hand upper, upper left hand cell, upper left hand cell. Suppose this is the table, this is the table. So just like what is the left upper cell? So this is the north, this is the south, this is the east, this is the west. So northwest corner cell. So northwest corner. So this is the northwest corner. So what is the left side upper hand? So this is the left side upper hand. This cell is the so left hand upper cell. So we have to identify that one. It means so that cell shows the northwest corner cell. Northwest corner cell. So first of all, we have to allocate that cell. Then go for the next. Okay, so exhaust the supply of each row before moving down the next row. So just like each row I have to exhaust it, so before going to the just going to the next row. Okay, next exhaust the warehouses requirements of each column before moving to the next column. Okay, next check to ensure that all the supplies and demands are met or not. Okay, so this is just like procedure steps for the initial, just like northwest corner rule. Okay, to find the initial basic feasible solution. Okay, let's see. So just like identify the first northwest corner cell and allocate as much as possible to the cell. Okay, cell of what cell? So upper left hand corner cell. Okay, so subjected to the supply and demand. Okay, so allocate as much as possible to the next adjacent feasible cell. So just repeat the step 1 and step 2 until all units of all supply and demands have been satisfied. So this is the process steps. Okay, so we'll see one numerical, then you can understand clearly how to solve initial basic feasible solution by using the northwest corner rule. Okay, so okay, already just like already told that just to solve any transportation model or any transportation problem, three things should be known. So the first one is the just like supply value should be known. These are the supply values. Okay, so next to demand value should be known. Demand value should be known. Okay, so that is the second thing. Third one is the shipping values. Okay, cost of shipping value should be known. So three values already given here. So we can go for the transportation, solving of the transportation model. So before going to any transportation model, you have to check, is it balanced problem or unbalanced problem? So what is balanced and unbalanced? Balanced means the number of supply is equal to number of demands. Okay, number of supply 100 plus 300 plus 300, 700. Okay, here also 300, 200, 200, 700. So this is the balanced problem. Number of columns should be equal to number of rows also. Okay, so if it is if the condition satisfied, that is the balanced problem. So if it is if the condition not satisfied, that is the unbalanced problem. If the unbalanced problems are given, then you have to convert into balanced problem by adding some dummy columns or dummy rows. We'll see in next classes also. So first we'll see the how to solve this one by the northwest corner rule. Okay, so just like just we'll see procedure steps. So that is the north west corner rule. Okay, so for the northwest corner means, so this is the direct, so east to west to north to south. So okay, northwest corner means, so this direction, what is the direction? Left hand upper side. Okay, left side upper hand. So in this table, so which cell is the left corner cell? It means so left hand upper cell or northwest corner cell. Okay, so you know that north, so west, this is the east and west, this is the south. Okay, so this direction. Okay, so So we have to identify that one. So identify the left side upper cell. It means northwest or northwest cell. So this is, so this cell is the, this cell is the northwest corner cell. Northwest corner cell. First we have to allocate that cell. Okay, how to allocate? So just I will explain, listen carefully. So for the allocation, so for the allocation of this cell has this is the demand rate is equal to 300. So supply rate is equal to 100. So to allocate the values, there are two values. So demand value and supply value. Every time we will get the two values. So in which we have to allocate first the minimum value. We have to allocate minimum value. So which is the minimum value here? So just like 100 is the minimum value compared to 300. So here we have to allocate the 100. How to allocate the 100? If you allocate 100 here, this 100 will be cancelled. If it is 0, then you can cancel this complete row. Okay. You can cancel this complete row. Then if you allocate 100 here, just like remaining value is equal to 200 here. Okay. So 300 will be cancelled. So 200. So just like remaining value. Then go for the, so next to identify the northwest corner cell. Northwest corner cell, it means that is the left side upper cell. So this is the just remaining cells. So in which, so what is the left side upper cell? This is the left side upper cell. Then you have to allocate this one. So for the allocation, two values are there. So what is the supply value is equal to 300. So demand value is equal to 200. Supply value is equal to 300 and demand value is equal to 200. We have to allocate the values. Which value have to allocate? Minimum value have to allocate first. So what is the minimum value here? 200, here 300. So we have to allocate 200 here. So 200. If you allocate 200 here, the 200 value will be cancelled, will be 0. So then you can cancel this complete column. Cancel this complete column. So if you give 200 allocation value here, just the remaining value is equal to 300 minus 200. 100 is a left. So 100 will be left. Okay. Next. So this is the just like remaining cells. So in which also you have to identify the just northwest corner cell. So it means that is the left upper cell. So left upper cell means this is the, then you have to allocate this cell. Okay. So for the allocation of this cell also, there are two values. One is 100, another one is 200. Okay. You have to allocate first to minimum value. What is the minimum value? 100 is the minimum value. So I have to allocate 100 here. 100. If you allocate 100 here, just to, this value will be cancelled. So the 100 will be cancelled. Then we can cancel this complete row. If you allocate 100 here, remaining value is equal to 200 minus 100 means 100. Okay. So remaining remaining cells. So these two values are the remaining cells. In which also we have to identify the northwest corner cell. It means left side upper cell. What is the left side upper cell? So this is the left side upper cell. So then you have to allocate this one. Okay. So for the allocation, there are two values. One is 300, another one is 100. Okay. So we have to allocate minimum value, which is minimum 100 value is the minimum. If you allocate 100 here, just like 100 will be cancelled, then you can cancel the complete column. Okay. Second column. So if you allocate 100 here, just remaining value is equal to 200. Okay. So last cell. So this is the last cell. So for the last cells, we should get the demand rate and supply rate should be equal. Okay. So it means if you get that one, our process is correct. Otherwise, something is mistakes happened in the just like our solving problem. Okay. So this is the 200. This is the 200. Then you can allocate 200 here. If it is 200, it will be 0. If it is 200, it will be 0. Then you can cancel this column. You can cancel this row also. Okay. So finally, 100 into 5 cost, 200 into 8 cost, 100 into 4 cost, 100 into 7 cost, and 200 into 5 cost. Here we can observe here. Just like. So this is the allocation cost. Okay, so just like it means, so this is the optimal transportation of products. It means so 100 products from factory D to warehouse here. Next, just 200 products from factory E to warehouse A. Okay, so similarly 100 products from factory E to warehouse B. Okay, just like from factory F to warehouse B, 100. So factory F to warehouse C, 200. So this is the optimized path. Okay, if you distribute like that one, you will get the minimum transportation cost. Okay, so you can just like calculate the minimum cost, transportation cost, 100 into 5 plus 200 into 8 plus 100 into 4 plus 100 into 7 plus 200 into 5. So this is the minimum cost value. Here you can observe. Okay, so 100 into 5 500, 100 into 200 into 8 1600, 100 into 4, that is the 400. So 100 into 7, that is the 700. 200 into 5, that is the 1000. So total transportation cost is equal to, so 4200. Okay, so by this method we can reduce the just like shipping cost or transportation cost. So if you just if you go randomly, automatically just like transport cost will be increases. So by using this transportation methods, by using this type of transportation methods, just like we can reduce the shipping cost or transportation cost. Okay, just like so in this way, just to we can solve the any numericals, just to by any transportation numericals by this method. Okay, so this is the one method only. So what is that northwest corner rule is the one method to solve the initial basic feasible solution. This is the only, just like initial basic feasible solution only. So this is only initial basic feasible solution. So just you have to check, is it optimized, or just like we have to go further that one. Okay, so for that one there is just like two more methods for to identification or for checking of the optimization. So you know that is the just like one is the stepping stone method, another one is the MODI method. Okay, so modified distribution method. Okay, by using those methods we can check the optimality. Okay so to solve the this initial basic feasible solution, two more methods are also there. So that is the just like least cost method and the Vogel's approximation method. Okay, so just like in next class, just like we'll solve few more or same numerical by least cost method and Vogel's approximation method. So then you can check the just like values of just like initial basic feasible solution values. So by northwest corner rule and least cost method and Vogel's approximation method, then we can check those just like which method is the just like gives the most good result or minimum transportation cost, and which method is best, we can identify that one also. Okay, so in next class we will see some more numericals to identify the basic initial basic feasible solution by just like northwest corner rule and least cost method and Vogel's approximation method. So after that, then you go for the optimality checking. Okay, we'll see one more numerical how to solve this transportation model by northwest corner rule. Okay, so just like this is the second numerical. So to solve the basic feasible solution by the northwest corner rule. Okay, you know that northwest corner rule, just like this is the north, this one is the south, this is the east, this one is the west. Okay, so the northwest corner cell, so this is just like left side upper, left side upper.
So left cell, upper cell, this one is the. So you have to choose that that cell, then you have to allocate that cell, then go for the next steps, just as we already explained in the previous numerical. Okay. So first of all, you identify which cell you have to allocate first. Okay. So this is the just like tabular form. So here also just like just to supply is given, the source S1 so can supply 7 and the source S2 can supply 9. So source S3 can supply 18. Okay. So just like demand, that is the destination. So the this demand is equal to 5 and just like for D2. So next warehouse or destination center, so demand is equal to 8. Okay. So next to 7. So that is the just like demand for the destination center D3, and 14 is the just like destination center for the D4. So first of all, just like we know that demand, you know, and the supply, you know, just here also just like shipping cost also given. Okay. Shipping cost of each unit from the source 1 S1 to source D1. So that is the 19 rupees. So similarly, source S1 to D2, that is the 30. Source S1 to D3, that is the 50. Okay. Source S1 to D4, so that is the just like 10. Okay. So these are the just like shipping cost values. So we know that, as you know, just like if you know the these three values, you can forward for the solving of transportation model. So by three methods. So in this class, we will just like we'll solve by the northwest corner road. Okay. So before going to that, just like we have to check, is it balanced matrix or not balanced? Is it balanced transportation or not balanced transportation? Just you have to add this one. So 77 plus 9, so 16 plus 18. Okay. So that is the 34. So similarly, 5 plus 7, 8 plus 7. Okay, 15 plus 5, 20. 20 plus 14, 34. So just like demand is equal to supply. So it is a balanced problem. Then you go for just like solving of this transportation model. So by northwest corner rule. Okay. So you know that northwest corner rule, you have to identify the northwest corner cell. So that is nothing but left side upper cell. So first you have to allocate that one, then you go for the next one. Okay. So in this matrix, just like you can identify that this is the left side upper cell. It means this is the just like northwest corner cell. Okay. So then you have to allocate first one. So for the allocation, there are two values. One is the 7, another one is the 5. So just like we know that. So we have to allocate minimum number first. Okay. This is the 5, this is the 7. So here we have to allocate 5. Okay. So just then if you allocate 5, then the 5 will be cancelled and we can cancel this complete column. Okay. Then 7 will be, so 2. So 7 minus 5. So 2 is the remaining value. Okay. So next, this is the just this is the just like cells. So here also you have to identify the just northwest corner cell. So it means left side upper cell. So what is the left side upper cell here? So this is the left side upper cell. Okay. Then you have to allocate that cell. So just like we have here for this cell, there are two values. One is the 8, another one is the 2. Okay. So which is minimum? 2 is minimum. Then you have to allocate 2 here. So this is 2. So if you allocate 2 here, this 2 will be cancelled, then automatically this row, complete row will be cancelled. So just 8 minus 2, just remaining value is equal to 6. Okay. So next, this is the cell. This one is the remaining blocks. Okay. Here also you have to identify the northwest corner cell. So just like northwest corner cell means, so we know that that is the left side upper cell. So this is the left side upper cell. Okay. So here there are two values. One is the 6, another one is the 9. Okay. So just like we know that just minimum value you have to allocate. So here 6 is minimum, then you can allocate 6. So if you allocate 6 here, then the 6 will be cancelled. The complete column will be cancelled. So just here 9 minus 6 means 3 will be remaining value. Okay. So next to the, this is the cell, these 4 cells. So in which you have to identify the, so northwest corner cell, northwest corner cell, it means, so that is the, so what is left side upper cell. So this is the left side upper cell. Okay. So you have to allocate the, just allocate this cell. So we know that there are 2 values for this cell, that is the 3, another the 7. So which is minimum? 3 is the minimum. So we have to allocate 3. So if you allocate 3 here, this 3 will be cancelled. Then the complete row will be cancelled. Okay. So 7 minus 3. So 4 is the remaining value. 4 is the remaining value. So, what are the just remaining cells? There are 2 cells. You know that left side upper cell. So there are 2 cells means left side cell you have to take. So because that is the northwest corner point. Northwest corner point. So here, so you have to allocate here. Here there are also 2 values. One is the 4, another one is the 18. So we know that 4 is the minimum value. Just we have to allocate the minimum value. So if you can allocate 4. Okay. If you allocate 4, this 4 will be cancelled. The complete column will be cancelled. Okay. Just 18 minus 4 means so 14 remaining. So last one is the remaining cell is the, this is the last cell. Here also this is the 14, this is the 14. This value should be equal for the last allocation cell. Okay. So just like if you get the equal values, then your process is good. Otherwise, so something mistake will have been happened, would been happened ever process. Okay. So this is the just like 14, this is also 14. Then you can allocate the 14. If you allocate 14 here, just this 14 will be 0, this 14 will be 0. Okay. So this will be cancelled, this will be cancelled. So this is the just finally the just allocated matrix is equal to, this is the allocated. Okay. So this is the allocated matrix, just like here we can identify that one. So 5 2 6 3 4 14. 5 2 6 3. So this is the 5 2 6 3 4 14. This is the allocated cell. Okay, just like here already noted here, just you can observe. So 5. So next to one second, I will to just I am repeating this one. So 5. If you allocate 5, just to here will be 0. So then here will be 2. Okay. Then next allocation cell is the 2. So just like if you allocate 2 here, so this will be 6. So this will be line cancel. Okay. So next allocation cell is equal to 6. So because this is 6. Okay. If you allocate 6 here, here this complete column will be cancelled. So this will be 3. Okay. So next up. So if you allocate 3 here, just like this will be 4. So this complete row will be cancelled. Okay. Next to if you allocate 4 here, this two remaining value is equal to this two. This 4 will be cancelled. So the complete column will be cancelled. Okay. So just like here, 18 minus 4 means 14. So just like if you allocate 14, just you can cancel. So both sides here also, here also. Okay. So this two, the allocated matrix is equal to this one. Okay. So that is the 5, 2, 6, 3, 4, 14. So allocated cost. So total transportation cost based upon the just northwest corner rule, that is the 5 into 19. So allocated value into just like shipping value. So 5 into 19 plus 2 into 30. So plus 6 into So 6 into 30 plus, so just like 3 into 40, so plus 4 into 70, so plus 14 into 20. So this is the least cost by the northwest corner road. Okay, so this is the values. So if you just like add the all the values, just like so this is the, just we will get 5 into 19, 2 into 30 plus 6 into 30 and 3 into 40, 4 into 70 plus just like 14 into 20. Okay, so if you add this one, just we will get this value. So just like by using the northwest corner rule, we will get the value. So minimum cost by transportation cost, that is the 1015 value. So by using northwest corner rule. So in this way, just like you can solve any transportation problems by just like least cost method. So this is the just like only this method or this rule gives the initial basic feasible solution. Then after that, you have to go for the optimization process. Is it optimized or not optimized then? Okay. So for that one, there is a just like two methods. So you know that is the one is the stepping stone method, another one is the Moody method. Okay. We'll see a few more numericals in next class. Thank you for listening to this class. Thank you.
Like, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.